in Japan last year, a 3 years old daughter, a girl, left in the bus. They go to school, they left in the bus. The school drivers left and parked in the car park. The girl died. And also Hanoi cases, also a student left in the bus. They go to school, I think 12 hours or 8 hours. 8 hours.
The sun.
Under the sun. So it's crazy. We launched myFirst. We kind of like bringing a concept called kids deserve a real tech. Kids also can use a watch and a phone concurrently. They just press and hold. Yeah, they just press and hold this one.
Okay.
And it will trigger SOS. Yeah. Yes. So we let the kids to report when they need help. So a lot of parents got concerned about giving phone early to the kids, right? They worry the kids like, this is a phone. They already keep walking, looking at the phone, right? Yeah. So this has been a very huge concern. But we still need to let the kids stay communicate and stay connected with the parents. So what is the better options? So we're thinking how to actually let it be lighter, easier to bring with the kids, and they don't need to carry about another things. They worry they lost it. So watch is a much better form factor. You wear on a watch, but of course, there's a lot of challenge. How to make such a big phone squeeze to such a small one? So that's the things that we are challenging and make it really good, really smaller and lightweight for the kids. And yet you need to achieve like all the communication functions and you need to add in cameras. So we know that actually even Samsung actually, they remove the camera because it's very difficult to combine everything together. So, but we make it, and the kids really like it. Apple Watch don't have camera, you cannot make video calls. Galaxy Watch don't have camera, you cannot make video calls. And ours have. I guess that will be the main difference. And also, of course, you can access everything, same as the application. You can go to social circles, you can browse to all the photos, social sharings, group chat, which is different from Apple and Samsung. This is a phone. Right?
Yeah, so.
This is a phone itself. So you don't need another device. You don't need another iPhone. You don't need another Samsung. Mm-hmm. And besides that, it works also on mobile application on iPhone or Android phone. So it's very simple. You just need to have, the parents need to create one ID. Mm-hmm. Then you can lock in on your watch, or you can lock in also on the phone. The phone can be an iPhone, can be a Samsung phone. So everything is from the cloud. So even you lost the device or you lost your phone, don't worry, you can get another phone. Your mom actually helps you to scan the QR code. Everything resumes. Yeah. So that's the beauty of our product. So even if you can make video calls, you can make voice call. We don't go through the GSM network. It's just a pure data. It's just like internet. So we work with Ericsson to provide the whole system. And Ericsson actually link us with like all the telco here to provide the baseband and network service. So we are not a MVNO. We are just an IoT device.
I thought you were a kind of MVNO.
Oh no. Yeah. So we're just an IoT device that comes with connectivity. Yeah. So rather than you need to connect Wi-Fi when you get home, we actually give you a LTE 4G that you can go anywhere to stay connected. Yeah. So according to the GFK report, we got number one market share for Singapore and Japan.
For the wearable
smartphone. So we found that actually like Singapore's right, one school start to have kids using it, slowly the whole class is using it. Yeah. So that's the network effect that we have. We are very adept to the market. So Singapore is a very small country. So we learn how to be international. We learn how to adapt different culture when we go to different countries. Which is why we tried a few years ago, we started with Japan. When we started in Japan, you know, everyone say, come on, G-Jay, there's no market for this product in Japan. I said, Japan kids don't wear watch. Then I said, Japan is very slow on taking up our technologies. I said, okay, but I still want to try. Because Japan is a very big market. Yeah, the kids population, I mean, in Asia side, besides China, yeah, it's a big market. And spending power is higher. China is difficult because our developments, everything is on Google OS.
I see.
It doesn't work.
yeah,
so So kind. Our R&D team got to redo everything for China. It's difficult. It's difficult. Yeah. So when we come to Japan, we manage to understand their needs. We break through. Like they have additional accessories like a lanyard, a pouch to cover it. Then they can hang it. Mm-hmm. They can hook to the back. Yeah. There's a lot of different cultures that they have. We adapt. We learn. And we design for them. Same to here. We launch our products, then we slowly learn from our cameras, and then now actually our myFirst phone. Yeah. Of course, later on we'll add in even more things. We want to understand their emotions, the mental health. All those algorithms later on we'll be adding in through the heart rate sensor, through the motions, through some of the feedbacks apps that they can feedbacks to the parents that I'm happy today, I'm not happy today. Through all the data analysis, then we can let the parents know the mental health of the kids. That's what we want to focus. All the car right now got sensor. Sooner or later, they have all the sensors into the car. And not just a sensor into the car to stop the car. It also have a sensors to beam the signals for all the wearable devices to know that actually some vehicles is coming nearer. There'll be alert. Definitely, there's API in the markets, there's AI API in the markets. Our role is actually to integrate the world advanced API into our device. So what we do is, as long as there's API in the markets that already come out, then we'll integrate into our system so that actually can alert our users. I see. It's not like we want to invent some things, then we go and collaborate with all the different car. That's difficult.
Right.
But now I actually got a lot of AI that the cars is implementing. They're actually opening up the APIs that we can implement in our system. So we will
regular. Any API?
There are a lot. There are too many right now. So I would think it needs some time to settle down and do consolidations. Because now if you integrate everything, you don't know who will last towards the end. It will take some time because the AI and the sensors is pumping up right now. So I think probably another 2 years, two or 3 years, then it will settle down. Then it will be a few core APIs that we can use. Right now we have hardware. You can do GPS tracking. So next time, even if you are using our applications on the mobile devices, same that you can do the GPS tracking as well. Yeah. So that's what we are doing. Yeah.